Greetings all, I am Burger coming to you from the bunker. Hey, today, what a treat we've got. I've got quite a few pieces of equipment. I haven't been out to the field and tested yet, so I kind of wanted to put some things together and try some stuff out. So first off, as I was thinking through this, safety always is extremely important. So if in fact you do have a grid down situation and you need to start preparing some food, whatnot, make sure that safety is always on the forefront of your mind. So number one, yes, cooking. This is a well-ventilated area. All preppers need to have a carbon monoxide detector in their homes. Multiple carbon monoxide detectors. That is extremely important. Secondly, when the power goes down, people are using candles and other flames, especially folks who don't use those on a regular basis. House fires are an extreme danger. So please be careful anytime that you're using flame, test things out, make sure that you're comfortable using your equipment. As you can see here, I do have my fire extinguisher ready to go. So safety is our primary concern. Hey, today I wanted to do use my new Stanley cook set, and this actually I got this just a couple weeks ago. Have not had a chance to use it, but I do have a Stanley cook set. Comes with a pot here, lid. Love this handle. I am going to see how hot it gets, but locks in place. And in addition, got a couple of cups. Now, this brings into play several of I Am Rugger's prepping theories. As you know, I'm always about thriving, not just surviving. So, in the end times, when the zombies come over the wall, if I'm not going to be able to have some coffee, I know my morale is going to be pretty low. So, today, I want to just try out. Like I said, I haven't had a chance to use this yet. And I want to try out making some coffee. I was going to use my grinder and French press, but I thought I would just go for today's purposes with the instant and see how everything worked. In addition to that, something I've already learned, I am using my Sterno kit here, and I wanted to see how this held up. But this is the correct type of fuel for the Sterno stove. You can see it's the green. However, the size of the fuel is a little smaller than I think this stove is designed for. Even though we're making it work here, it's not exactly right. Did want to say that I was able to also use for the first time in a practical situation my refillable, I call it the flamethrower. So did get this on sale. Which brings into play another of I Am Rugger's concepts here, prepping on a budget. So I did get 1/3 off on the lighter. In addition to that, you know, picked up things like, you know, when you go out for fast food and you don't use some of the plasticware, just throw that in a box or a sack somewhere, and you got utensils, you got a lot of condiments. Sometimes you might even have paper products that you can store away. So basically what we're going to do here is, and this has been going for a few minutes. I know you guys didn't want to sit here and just watch the water get warm. But we did go with about 8 ounces of water. And we're going to try to just make some instant coffee, see how things go. I wanted to give this about 10 minutes of prep time. So I wanted to see if this fuel and this setup was going to be enough. I'm not going to probably bring the water to a full boil, but it should be warm enough, hopefully, for a successful test to make some pretty delicious coffee. I do have to say that I am not a coffee snob, so I do like my fresh ground. I do have redundant systems for coffee. So we've got a French press system for the fresh ground, like all Americans probably. I've got my K-cups that I'm addicted to. Even though they do produce a lot of plastic, I do use refillable K-cups. And then, you know, I'm going to supplement that redundant systems because two is one, one is none with the instant. So have plenty of that going on here today. So it has been, you know, it's getting about 8 minutes on my water. I can't see some bubbles forming. I'm gonna say that 8 minutes in, that's going to be pretty close. If I would have used this lid, we probably would have been further along. And the other thing about this Stanley cook kit is I have heard a couple of things that we need to be aware of. If you are using this on a, say, wood fire source outside, like a campfire, need to be very careful about the plastic, make sure the flames are not coming over the top. I have heard reports, even though obviously I've not experienced it, that this plastic can melt. Additionally, some folks have struggled with these handles. I have found that it locks in place very nicely. It does have this slide for, you know, further benefit, keeping it from locking or from sliding out of place. But I've not had any trouble with this, so perhaps the version I've gotten, they've improved that design. So I do have to say, so far I've been very pleased with this. So yeah, I wish I would have put that lid on. And we're going about 9 minutes. We do have bubbles forming in the bottom, so I'm gonna call that pretty good for our purposes here of coffee manufacturing. Probably not exactly the right term, but we're gonna go ahead and go for it. So yeah, that is 8 ounces, 9 minutes. Oh hey, look at that. That is plenty of water for my travel cups here that come with the Stanley cook kit. And we are just gonna see how this works this morning. Yeah, extremely warm, extremely hot. That's some mighty fine H2O right there. So we're gonna call that a success. So what we've done here this morning is we have tried out our Stanley cook set. Also, in addition to that, I put a couple of my systems together with the Sterno stove, as well as the Sterno fuel. So I think things that I personally have learned, A, safety always is a number one priority. I am a little concerned, and this is, you know, on many of the reviews, these things, you know, the durability of the Sterno stove in harsh conditions, if you're out bushcrafting, out backpacking, I don't think you can beat these things around a lot. I am very pleased with how the Stanley cook kit did perform. This is stainless steel, looks like the transfer of heat is very efficient, didn't take any time at all. So I'm gonna call that a success. Viewers, subscribers, leave your comments down below. What can we do better? What did we do well? As always, this is I Am Rugger coming to you from the bunker. Let's be careful out there.